on stage. But while many things have changed, many of the challenges that I faced on graduation day still stand before you. And that's what I want to talk about today, how you meet and overcome those challenges. A stagnant economy, great jobs are still hard to come by, poverty, gun violence, and addiction still plague many of our communities. And we had, in 1988, a lot of political turmoil. Surprise, surprise. You guys have a lot of political turmoil. The world's circumstances guaranteed that many of my classmates would face adversity. These are challenging times. The same is true today as it was for me. There are those on the right and the left who would seek to divide us, to focus on our differences. But I assure you, your parents, your professors, those who have brought you here today to this great day of celebration, this day of achievement, will also see you through all those challenges, the ones we face today. You are ready to thrive, ready to make your mark. So my message is this, that your success is less dependent on your IQ and your EQ, and more dependent on what I call AQ, your adversity quotient, your ability to overcome challenges and failures and still get up and still keep moving forward. As you experience challenges, keep in mind that they will be balanced with many blessings. I'm here to tell you that it is often through your adversity that you truly find your life's purpose. That has been the story of my life. I'm sure, as you heard, my childhood was not unlike many of yours. Born in Newark, New Jersey, an urban environment full of challenges, a family of divorce, suffering some financial struggles, a son of immigrants. Then, at 13, it happened. I lost my dad to violence. He was gunned down in the street right in front of me. I held him as he died, covered in blood. Nothing can prepare you for that. But believe me when I tell you, and this is the surprise, that even in that horror, I found great hope. That single event became the driving force in my life, a life of purpose. Sure, nothing can make up for that loss, but I was blessed with an incredible stepdad that changed my life, who restored my faith and gave me strength to turn away from violence and bitterness. I found strength in my faith and my family. And yes, there was a football family and a Wagner family that helped make a difference to me. That really helped. And I learned to get back up. I found my life's purpose. In that personal crisis, I found the passion to fight to prevent violence, to work to improve people's lives, a passion to serve, a passion that many of you have and have learned here in Philadelphia. What was here at Wagner, what was the most horrible event in my life was the opportunity that I had to meet the first lawyer that I ever met, to watch those proceedings. And actually, I was a freshman at Wagner when I testified in that trial and learned about the criminal justice system. If it wasn't for that horrible occasion, I would have never gone to law school. So what life intended for evil has become a blessing overall. Now, as you sit here today, you may have your doubts about yourself. I know I did. You may fear the uncertainty of an unknown future. You may question your ability to get back up every single time. Throughout your life, you will face challenges. You will have failures. There will be dark days. That is a hard truth. But you will also have days of great triumph. Days like today. I promise you, if you push through those challenges with grit and determination, you will be rewarded. That has been my experience. I have known the heartbreak of losing football games and missing the playoffs. But I have also known the glory of winning a national championship right here at Wagner College. I have felt the sting of being cut by a football team, but I have also known the joy of signing an NFL contract. I have known the disappointment of that first grade in law school. Wow. But I have also felt the honor of graduating law school with distinction and passing the bar exam my very first time. Yes, I have suffered personal tragedies, but I have also helped manage a great city and worked to improve the lives of so many that I can't even count. I suffered a setback just this week, losing an incredibly difficult election, taking on a self-funded millionaire and a billionaire super PAC. But I also connected with thousands of people, citizens and voters, and those who were vulnerable, and shared a vision for our city that I know lives on today. I know all of you can rise to your occasion. As we come together to celebrate your success, each of you should be proud of your work and of your purpose. Fear not, you are up to the challenge. Your parents, your professors, and Wagner has prepared you for that. I know that your adversities will also bring great triumphs. In closing, I want to leave you with a few simple truths to remember and that you can apply in your life every single day. Always speak truth to power. Always speak truth to power. Stay true to your values, no matter what. Have the courage right now to take risks. Do not be afraid. Become better, not bitter, when you face adversity. Dare to achieve. Aspire to greatness. Work for a more just society. Do not fear failure. Be bold. Take on the big fights. Fight to safeguard our highest ideals as Americans. And here's something really important. Don't wait your turn. I'm going to say that again. Don't wait your turn. We need your talents and your leadership today, right now. Let your life speak. And whatever you do next, as they say, don't count your days, but make your days count. Remember those things, and your triumphs will outnumber your tragedies, and you will all be champions in life. God bless you. Thank you very much.